Good evening. Myself, Dr. Raghunandan. I am head of intensive care unit of Tumkur Covid Hospital and Aruna Hospital, Tumkur. Today, I would like to share one of my experience of a patient by name Shashikala, 55 years, female. She was having comorbid disease of diabetic and hypertensive. She was diagnosed with SARS-CoV-19 3 months back. And she got admitted in our hospital in Tumkur Covid Hospital in ICU with severe respiratory distress, acute respiratory distress, ARDS. She was there almost for 38 days in ICU with non-invasive ventilation, NIV, and she was having a CT severity score of 25 bar 25, and she had bilateral obesities. The condition was bad. Then with treatment of COVID with remdesivir and all, she hardly improved over the days. Around 22nd day, we could wean off her from ventilator, put her on NRBM, after which still our requirement of oxygen was more, around 10 to 12 liters. We would hardly get her off oxygen, because with the off oxygen, her saturation used to drop like come to 30 to 40%. Then with intensive spirometry, chest physiotherapy, awake proning, and with supportive medication, she improved a little bit, but we could understand that over a period of 50 days, she has become oxygen dependent. And the only way out are two ways are there. One is lung transplant. The other one is to support her with oxygen therapy round the clock at her home. The second option was what the patient attenders opted for. So this was the time when I came in touch with Dozee. Mr. Mudit of Dozee was very forthcoming in giving me a Dozee machine to do this contactless monitoring of this patient Shashikala at home, so that I can try out my whatever knowledge I have acquired of COVID with my pulmonologist Dr. Manjunath to be my aide in this process. Sir, we started the recording her vitals like respiratory rate, saturation, heart rate, blood pressures, and we tabulated it in a way so that we started to decrease her oxygen requirement depending upon our contactless recordings, whatever the data which used to be coming over the time. And we used to tell the patient attender to increase the oxygen flow whenever she used to desaturate. And once the patient started getting used to this, she also cooperated. She was very reluctant to do incentive spirometry or allow us to do chest physiotherapy, which was difficult for us in the initial stages in our ICU stay. But once she went back home, she got into her own environment, she started responding positively to our treatments. And today I can tell that we have almost succeeded in making her to come off oxygen. As such, now our oxygen requirement is around 1 to 1.5 liters, which is actually a very good success for the whole team. And it could be only happening with the help of Dozee, because when we monitor a patient, we monitor with certain vitals which don't give actually the complete picture. So what we do is we take them into intensive care, where intensivists or a physician will take care of the patient over a long period of time. Corona has been teaching us so many newer modules of treatment which were not there earlier, or we never had usage of HFNC. HFNC was morely used for pediatric patients, where HFNC became one of the mode of treatment for oxygen therapy in COVID.